Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your teacher, Phyllis Tirit. Today I'm going to take you through English Form 4, Lesson 10. Our topic will be on writing and the subtopic will be on essays. Welcome. So we'll begin with the lesson objective. Expect that by the end of the lesson or the lesson, you'll be able to define an essay and describe the characteristics of a good essay. So in writing of a good essay, an essay is a written speech used to talk about a specific topic. From the picture posted over there, you can see that is a person trying to write an essay. So in writing an essay, or when writing an essay, you should analyze the essay topic. One, understand the topic that you're dealing with so that you can be having an idea of what the topic is all about. That's the second one. The third one, write down the gathered information and make sure they are in accordance with the essay topic. Number four, combine the strong points by writing them in prose. Can we look at an example of an essay here, over there? Women are portrayed as loving and self-sacrificing in Henrik Ibsen's A Doll's House. Write an essay to show the truth of this statement. Therefore, try to go through this essay because it's already an essay. So in writing an essay, we say you need to analyze the topic, understand the topic you're dealing with, write down the gathered information, and combine the strong points by writing them in prose. So what are the characteristics of a good essay? A good essay should contain the following: beginning, that's the introduction, the body, ending with the conclusion. Therefore, an essay has the following. An essay has a beginning, middle, and an end. It uses paragraphs and it needs to be clearly understood. In the beginning, it has at least three sentences. The first sentence has the introduction and main overview of the main and primary topic. The first sentence has the introduction and main overview and the primary topic of the essay. Those are at least the three sentences in the introduction. Then the second sentence contains the thesis statement. Statement that proves a point. So in the thesis statement is where can you refer your strong points to the body of the essay. Or introduce to us the essay. Tell us what you know about the essay that has been posted to you as a question. Number three, the third sentence is a conversation to start in the body section. So in the body is the main section of the essay. It can be put into many paragraphs with regard to the content of the writer. The body talks about the subjects or the main points. Then each paragraph has a different subtopic, whereby each topic talks about a different idea. It gives all information being presented. All you can say is that at the body is where you let your content flow, and at the body is where still the writer checks on your grammar. So at the body, make sure you have the good grasp of the main points. Explain them in paragraphs, each with a different subtopic, and give all the information that you have. Then at the ending, your ending, you should sum up the entire essay. And you can end with the following. Restate your topic, restate your thesis statement, briefly touch on every topic in your essay in the last sentence, and in most essays, the ending paragraph is what people remember. Now, can we look at an example of this essay over there? At the introduction, attention grabs the first sentence, briefly explain for opening, thesis statement, address it promptly. That is what should be included in the introduction, because we said it should contain at least three sentences, and those are the key sentences. At the body, now elaborate your thesis, that is follow your points. Describe any obstacles you encountered, and describe how you overcame these. In an essay, try to discuss or try to list your main points with a subtopic in each paragraph, And in the conclusion, explain how this experience mirrors the audience and their values or beliefs. Emphasize any lessons you learn. Thank the committee reviewing your essay. Having said that at the end of our lesson, try the following assignment. Write an essay with the support that fortune can sometimes lead to calamities and bad omens with reference to The Pearl by John Steinbeck. You can also refer the essay writing to Excelling in English, Students Book 4, second edition, printed by the Kenya, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can as well reach us for more on our SMS line as posted on the screen, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till another time.